Is there anything I can do to make you stop cleaning? Other than pointing out that this isn't your house? Or a house.
It's almost 4 years since we got engaged and we don't even have a date.
Yeah, look, I know you're upset, but the important thing is... Okay, I might need a little help with what to say, so I'm just gonna dive right in. Do you think Paul has another family?
Jack!
I told you I'm gonna need a little help.
All right, well, start by asking me how I'm feeling.
How are you feeling, Brooke?
I don't know. I'm confused. I'm questioning my whole relationship. Okay, well, now ask me what I really want.
Oh! What do you really want?
I don't know, Jack. Will you stop being Mr. Fix-It? I mean, why are Paul and I taking so long? Am I being an idiot?
No, no, you're not an idiot. But I do think that you are the one who is now avoiding the conversation. You should talk to Paul.
Yeah, you're right. Talk we should have had years ago. Thanks, Jack.
But again, all this is meaningless if he does, in fact, have another family. What a disgusting generation. You don't ever need me to do something like that, right?
Oh, God, no. But thanks for being there for me in your own special way.
You're welcome. I got a rain check for that helicopter ride. Maybe we can take it after your next divorce.
Hey, Jack. I wanted to say thank you. I had a talk with Paul. Turns out it was way overdue.
Oh my God, he has two families?
No. But we were both afraid that the other one was having cold feet. We finally got into it and we set a date. We're gonna get married in May.
How did he break it to his first wife? I'm sorry. It's great. Congrats. Surprising.
Oh, that's Paul now. Hello, Mr. Teapot.
You good?
I don't know.
That sounds like a thread we don't want to pull. Plus, your sad posture makes your pecs look great.
Thank you.